The United States condemns today's two bombings that took place at mosques in Pakistan, which brutally targeted innocent people at worship. By attacking places of worship, whoever was responsible has demonstrated a clear lack of disregard for the Pakistani people and for the peaceful religion they practice. The United States will continue to work with the government of Pakistan to combat violent extremism and terrorism, and our thoughts and our prayers go out with the families and friends of those who were touched by these attacks. And finally, just an update, the USAID Administrator Rajiv Shah is traveling to India as part of President Obama's delegation to promote the U.S.-India strategic partnership. Development cooperation obviously forms an important part of their agenda. This is a relationship that's gone on, obviously, for nearly 60 years. The U.S. government, through USAID, has supported India's development, and over that time, USAID's assistance has evolved from humanitarian aid to infrastructure development and institution building to support for economic reforms. That's all I have. Do you want to go ahead and, Bob?
Do you have any update on the Secretary's plans to meet with Prime Minister Netanyahu next week?
I don't, beyond what PJ referred to yesterday, which is that they plan to meet, certainly, but the time and the date are to be worked out. I can't confirm that right now, but as the Secretary said yesterday in New Zealand, she very much wants to meet with Prime Minister Netanyahu, and they just need to work out a time and a place.
Do you anticipate there'll be any media availability with that, or we'll even be able to go in and get any video of the meeting itself?
Well, I'll have to get back to you. Once we've determined where it's going to take place, the venue, then we can provide information about media access. Well, the Secretary's party is down for the night, so maybe later today. We'll try to get you an answer on that. As soon as we have anything to announce, obviously we will. Go ahead.
Is it just a coincidence that Foreign Minister Ahmed Abdelghait from Egypt is coming next week? Is there any possibility that he will meet Secretary Clinton and Prime Minister Netanyahu? Is there any progress in the talks between the two?
I'm not aware that there's any anything planned, that there's any meetings planned. I'm not, frankly, aware of his schedule or who in the State Department will meet with them, but I can get more information on that for you. Yeah, sure.
Saab Erekat, the chief Palestinian negotiator, was quoted yesterday that the U.S. asked the Palestinians to give them two more weeks to try to convince Israel to freeze settlements. You know, and the Arab League gave the U.S. a one-month period, which will end on Monday.
Well,
can you comment on this?
I really can't. As we've said time and time again from this podium, as well as Senator Mitchell and Secretary Clinton, we're not going to talk about the details. They did meet yesterday. He did meet with Senator Mitchell, but I'm not going to get into what they discussed. But obviously, we remain hard at work, and our priority remains getting the two sides back into direct negotiations. Yeah, Michelle.
He also talked about one option that the Palestinians are weighing seriously is going to the United Nations and asking for a UN to declare a Palestinian state.
And again,
what's your position on that?
Well, we talked about this yesterday. Our goal remains getting both sides back into direct negotiations. It is ultimately the only way that all of these outstanding issues are going to be resolved. And so anything that might affect getting both parties back into direct negotiations, we would discourage, frankly. Yeah, go ahead.
There's a report on the wires that President Abbas, according to a report on CNN website in Arabic, is saying that the U.S. promised the Palestinians that they will support them when they decide to go to the U.N. to ask for the declaration of a state if the process didn't work out. I'm sure you are not going
to... I haven't seen his comments, so I can't give any kind of reaction to them. But I just stated what our position is. You know, we remain convinced that ultimately the only way that we're going to get a comprehensive peace is through direct negotiations, and anything that might affect those direct negotiations, we feel is not helpful or not constructive. Yeah, go ahead.
The International Relations Committee in the House changing hand with Representative Eliana lieutenant is taking the presidency or the chairman seat on the committee. This is stirring a lot of worries everywhere, about, you know, in the circles of those people who are looking for realistic peace or efforts, U.S. efforts to bring peace in the Middle East. How much, how is the State Department going to deal with this problem with Mrs. Liliana, Lieutenant, is very hardliner, so closely, her thoughts, her beliefs, her ideology is so closely allied with Netanyahu, hardline kind of policies. Do you see any way that the State Department can actually bring the Congresswoman Lilian to a more practical and understanding of the needs for the peace in the Middle East and for the implementation of UN resolutions accordingly?
Well, we've talked a lot over the last couple of days about the new Congress and its possible effects on foreign policy and the conduct of foreign policy. The Secretary has, in fact, been reaching out and to the new chairwoman. I don't know if she has already or plans to, but obviously to just extend our good wishes, congratulate her and her other colleagues, and also to pledge our willingness and our commitment to work closely with Congress on a broad range of issues, but including Middle East peace. It is a priority for this administration. It's going to remain a priority for this administration. And obviously, we're going to work hand in glove with Congress to advance direct negotiations and to ultimately reach a settlement.